class. Today we're going to talk about section 4.2, solving equations, or solving quadratic equations, excuse me, by graphing. So you'll notice that we're doing the same steps to begin with that we did in section 4.1. We'll find A, B, and C. So our coefficients are 1, 2, and negative 8. Our y-intercept is always 0, c, so 0, negative 8. The x-coordinate of the vertex, again, that formula is the opposite of b over 2a. So the opposite of 2 over 2 times 1 would be negative 2 over 2, which is negative 1. The axis of symmetry is x equals negative 1. I'm going to go ahead and put that on here as I go. Okay, the y-coordinate of the vertex, we would plug in a negative 1 into the function. Now simplify, negative 1 squared is 1. Plus 2 times negative 1 would be minus 2, minus 8. So 1 minus 2 is negative 1, minus 8 is negative 9. The vertex will be at negative 1, negative 9. So we can fill in right here under axis of symmetry and vertex. And we can put the point negative 1, negative 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Negative 1, negative 9 is your vertex. Our y-intercept was 0, negative 8. So let's plot it. 0, negative 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, I'm giving you one of the x-intercepts, which is a solution. Once we have it, we will see where the other x-intercept is. Also, note that there would be a point right here. Okay, so we're going to plug in 2 into this function. So we'll have 2 squared plus 2 times 2 minus 8 would be 4. Plus 4 minus 8, you see that that gives you 2, 0. 2, 0. So that's 3 away from the axis of symmetry. So our other solution, or 0, would be 3 away on the left side. 1, 2, 3. And that point was at negative 1, 2, 3, 4. So negative 4. Negative 4, 0. So we would graph, and I'll try my best, the function. And those solutions are where we cross the x-axis, so that was at x is 2 and negative 4. On B, we'll label our A, B, and C. Again, our coefficients, 1, negative 4, and C is negative 5. Our y-intercept is at 0, C, so 0, negative 5. Let me just go ahead and put that on the chart and on the graph, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Our axis of symmetry, again, it's the opposite of B over 2A. So the opposite of negative 4 over 2 times 1 would be 4 over 2, which equals 2. The axis of symmetry is x equals 2. Okay, so that it would be right here. I'm sorry if my head is in the way. the y-coordinate of the vertex, we plug in the axis of symmetry value, the x value. 2 squared would be 4, minus 4 times 2 would be 8, so that would be negative 4 minus 5 would be negative 9. So our axis of symmetry is at 2, or our vertex, excuse me, is at 2, negative 9. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I should mention that we would have another point right here. Okay, one of our zeros, which is a solution, is at 5. If you plug in the 5 into the function, this would be 25 minus 20 would be 5, minus 5 would be 0, so 5, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're 3 away from the axis of symmetry to the right. Let's go 3 away to the left. And then we'll mark that down. That would be x was negative 1. So the other x-intercept is negative 1, 0. Graph the function. And our two solutions are where we're crossing the x-axis, which was at 5 and negative 1. Okay, our last example, C. Our coefficients this time we would have A would be negative 1, B is 1, and C is 6. So our y-intercept is at 0, 6. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, 6. We'll go in the chart or table. The x-coordinate of the vertex, negative b over 2a, or the opposite of b over 2a, so the opposite of 1 over 2 times negative 1. Would be negative 1 over negative 2, which is 1 half. So our axis of symmetry is x equals 1 half. So I'm just going to draw that the best I can. And then we're going to plug in a 1 half and to find the y coordinate. Negative, or 1 half squared is 1 fourth. Negative 1 fourth plus 1 half plus 6 would be equal to 6 and 1 fourth. So our vertex is 1 half, 6 and 1 fourth. 1 half, 6 and 1 fourth. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and a fourth, just a little bit up here. So we'd have another point just a little ways past this point. And just imagine those are at the same location. Close enough for now. And I think I put that on there, right? Let's see. 0, 6. And it looks like I may have something off on this one because it should open down. Not seeing it. Let's see. 6 1/4. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. not seeing where I'm off. Oh, I see where I'm off. I put a point. Maybe y'all had already recognized this. I put a point right here next to where the vertex is, rather than putting it on this side of the axis of symmetry. That's why I'm off. Okay, now we're back on track. We're going to plug in and do the opposite of 3 squared plus 3 plus 6. Now I'm going to try to squeeze this in. That would be negative 9 plus 3 plus 6, which will give us 0. So we have a point at 3, 0. So we're going over 3 fourths here, and then over to 3. So we're going over 2 and 3 fourths. So on this side, this is a fourth. We're going this way. We're going to be over in here a little ways. And let's see what that value would be. It should be at negative, actually it should be at negative 2. See how close we are? Let's just call it negative 2. Negative 2, 0. And then we'll draw our line. And put our two solutions were 3 and negative 2. And if we try in the negative 2, negative 2 squared would be 4. The opposite of 4 would be negative 4 plus plus a negative 2 would be negative 6, plus 6 would be 0. So that does work in the function. Okay, well that's it on section 4.2, solving quadratic equations by graphing. I hope you have a great rest of your day.